Nowadays, aquaculture farming has been more complicated compared to the past decades. Several inputs are to be considered, particularly the use of artificial diets or feeds, which covers 50 to 60% of the total production cost. But in this case, accumulation of waste is inevitable from uneaten feeds and other waste products. Fish ponds are considered as large comfort zones for aquatic species which are present. All of the feces and urine they excrete goes directly to the pond bottom, which increases decomposition rate and organic matter due to increase in bacterial activity. Bacteria and plankton are the primary consumers of oxygen in an aquatic environment. Fish and other aquatic species are only secondary consumers. Massive levels of each can cause imbalance in the ecosystem, which eventually leads to fish kill. Thermal stratification exists in an aquatic environment. It is the condition where different temperatures are observed on the different layers of the pond. At this condition, a physical barrier is created, thus dissolved oxygen cannot be transferred into deeper areas. It increases accumulation of trapped gases in the hypolimnion, including carbon dioxide at a more significant amount. During low pressure, surface water starts to cool down. Water in the surface becomes heavy and eventually sinks to the bottom. A displacement happens where toxic gases are released from the bottom, causing significant oxygen depletion. When fish kill happens in Taal Lake, Batangas, an overturn happens as cool water at the top of the lake becomes heavier and goes down, while warm water rises to the surface. This process causes sulfur and other organic matter on the lake bottom to rise and affect the fish in the cages. In addition, upwelling normally occurs in deep bodies of water wherein sunlight usually don't penetrate the lower stratum of the water body, thus it is devoid of oxygen. The gassing tower technology addresses thermal stratification. It increases water circulation and movements, thus increasing the capacity of water to acquire oxygen in the atmosphere and transforming it into dissolved oxygen state, which is consumed by the fish for respiration. Toxic gases are the gassing tower. Ideally, a 20-foot tower is advised in constructing a gassing tower. 5 feet of the tower is submerged in the water. The remaining 15 feet of the tower is divided into 4 layers made up of chicken wires or other materials that will enable the breakdown of water into smaller particles. At the center of the tower, there should be a PVC pipe used as the inlet and outlet of the water. A submersible pump or diesel pump is used in the suction process of the water. Then it is released to the top of the tower, following a fountain effect. Falling water is then broken down into smaller particles, increasing its capacity to absorb oxygen in the atmosphere as it falls down layer by layer in the chicken wires. The process is repeated for several hours. The tower is usually operated in times of the day where dissolved oxygen levels are low. This tower can truly help aquaculturists to attain good quality of fishes during harvest. Most importantly, can maintain reasonable profit that will sustain the livelihood and subsistence of both small-scale and large-scale operators in the aquaculture industry.